Many of us have introduced amendments to try to make this bill better. We understand the safety of police officers. We also understand the safety of our public. You know, I get it. I have family that are in law enforcement. My godfather, a lifelong county sheriff. My sister-in-law, a Philadelphia police officer. I have two young sons who one day might want to be a police officer. But as I sit and I look at those two boys, and I realize that one day they will be two grown black men here in Philadelphia. And I understand the risk that they have, that unfortunately they are more likely to have a negative interaction with a police officer than a positive one. And I wonder, what would I want to happen should that be the case? Would I want to know what happened, who had injured my son? But what if they became that police officer? Wouldn't I also want their safety? It's complicated. It's a difficult question. And we have a balancing act here. But what I'll tell you is that it already exists. The question about whether or not to release a police officer's name is not a question that I think this body should answer. It is one that I rest in the hands and the decision of our local police chiefs and commanders. I believe that they understand the climate in which these incidents happen, that they would want to protect their own police force just as much as we do. And whether it be a day after the incident, a week after the incident, 30 days, maybe even 60 days, they are in the best position to make that decision. Not us, not here, not in Harrisburg. We do not have the eyes on the ground to make the appropriate decision at that time. For those reasons, while we've debated transparency, while we've debated public safety, while we've debated the health and security of our police officers, I trust those decisions to be in the ones who are there on the ground every day with those officers, with their police chiefs and commanders, not with us, not with you. And for those reasons, I urge us all to vote no. Thank you.